Have you ever wondered if the makeup and skincare that you use might be affecting your eyes? Well, I'm an optometrist specializing in dry eye and ocular surface issues, including the effect of makeups and skincare on the ocular surface. And recently, I started a new business within my eye care practice called Visionary Esthetics. In this video, I'll talk about how aesthetics and the eye are related and why it actually makes sense that I would have aesthetics in my eye care practice. Welcome to Eye School with Dr. D, where my goal is to arm you with the knowledge you need to take control of your eye health and have the best vision possible. Like and subscribe for videos every week. You've made it to Eye School with me, Dr. D. In today's lesson, we're talking about aesthetics in the eye. In other words, what does my beauty routine have to do with my eyes? Well, actually, lots. So stick around for today's video to learn more. Before we get started today, I want you to know that this channel is all about eye education and we've built a great community here. And so I would love nothing more than for you to share your experiences and expertise with beauty and skincare and how it's affected your eyes down below so that we can all learn from each other. And if this video is helpful to you today, please consider subscribing as I am posting new videos weekly. So it may seem odd to hear of an eye doctor with aesthetics in their clinic. Like, does your eye doctor have facials in their clinic? No, it sounds very, very different. But in actuality, optometrists have a unique opportunity to be a key player in this field of ocular aesthetics. Everyone, all of my patients, myself, my whole team, we all want to look our best, and the eyes are among the most important aesthetic features of your face. Especially in the last year, year and a half, during this pandemic, there's been a major focus on your eyes because we're covering up half of our faces with a mask. Now, historically, ocular aesthetic services have primarily been focused on surgeries, right? So blepharoplasties, I made a video about blepharoplasty, and other eyelid procedures, whether you have a drooping eyelid, lids that turn in or out. But really, most of our ocular aesthetic things have been procedures and surgeries. However, recently there's been a shift to more non-surgical description of ocular aesthetics. So one that not only includes the eyes, but the skin and the face, around the eyes. And as an optometrist, over the past 10 years, I've been asked about my recommendations for makeup and skincare routines enough times daily, honestly, to finally realize that I needed to be paying attention to these questions and coming up with answers. So my aesthetics journey started with my dry eye clinic. When patients have dry eye, meibomian gland dysfunction, and allergies, the appearance as well as the comfort of the eyes is compromised. In that case, treating the ocular surface can improve comfort, restore vision, and enhance the aesthetics of the eyes. If you're here because you suffer from dryness of your eyes, one of the first things patients will say to me is they don't like how their eyes look. People are asking them if they've been drinking or if they've taken drugs or what's wrong. Have you been crying? Because their eyes are always looking red. So we focus a lot on this channel about how the eyes feel and how your vision functions. But truly, when you have dry eyes or allergies in your eyes, I mean, people are concerned about, my patients are concerned about how their eyes look and how they look to others as well. So the overlap comes in the fact that some of the treatments for dry eye, the new FDA approved treatments like intense pulse light, have secondary aesthetic perks. IPL not only decreases ocular inflammation, but it also reduces facial skin redness, telangiectasias, which are these little blood vessels that pop up on the skin, hyperpigmentation, age spots, fine lines, and wrinkles. LED therapies have implications for the ocular surface and controlling the inflammation associated with meibomian gland dysfunction, but they have secondary aesthetic benefits as well when it comes to acne and rosacea. So patients care about ocular aesthetics and they should be getting their information from knowledgeable, reputable sources. Eye care professionals like myself should be talking to their patients about how makeup, skincare, and beauty products affect the health and functionality of the eyes. I've said it before, I'll say it 100 more times, what goes around your eyes ends up in your eyes. And so it matters the makeup you wear, the lashes you wear, the serums you use, the skincare products you use. I'm very passionate about this topic, and I'll be linking an aesthetic playlist down below of all of the product reviews, preservatives to avoid, and the reviews of eye-safe makeup lines that I've done in the past so that it's in one easy-to-view place. Optometrists are the predominant primary eye care professionals in the United States, which means our profession has the opportunity and the responsibility to talk about eye health in relation to beauty and skincare products. So what I've chosen to create in my practice is an aesthetic clinic that has a culture of eye-focused health. I've created a protocol for facials that incorporates special procedures to enhance the eyes. We stock eye-friendly makeup here and skincare here in the office. We're proactively asking our dry eye and even our regular eye exam patients about their skincare, their makeup, serums, and lash habits, and we take an eye history of our patients getting facials. We're discussing things like Lumify for eye brightening and whitening, and Upnique for lifting the eyelids. And we're aiming to help our patients achieve healthy and beautiful eyes. You should see clearly, your eyes should feel comfortable. We want them to be healthy forever, but they can be beautiful too. So I'm so excited to see how this new part of our clinic grows and develops. And if you're interested in ocular aesthetics and live in my area, we would love to see you. If you're not local, I'm gonna leave the names of some awesome optometrists throughout the country who are doing what I'm doing, leading the way with adding this proactive approach to ocular aesthetics in their practices. So if you're anything less than thrilled with how your eyes look, I would invite you to come check out our new ocular aesthetics clinic, Visionary Aesthetics at Salisbury Eye Care and Eyewear. That is going to be it for today's iSchool lesson. I'll see you next time. Class is dismissed.